Good morning, people. Just hanging out in my yard. It's been raining here where I'm located. No sun out yet. Just enjoying the sounds of the insects and the birds. And that can be very comforting. I want to thank all the humanitarians on the planet, all the people that are looking out for other people, for the little people, all over the globe. There is beautiful, wonderful people doing wonderful acts for people that are in need. And we have a real need for people to express concern for their fellow man, woman, child. And I know a lot of people have expressed that I've been operating in my ego. But ego isn't always bad, people. Sometimes you have to use your ego to overcome obstacles. And if I were purely in my ego, I would not have survived what I've survived so far. It's heart motive. My motives towards all beings are not bad. And the creator of all that exists, I think, knows that my motives in my heart and willingness to learn and to accept people and things as they are is a mastery. I also want to thank all the humanitarians on the planet for their wonderful deeds of kindness towards those who are in need of those acts of kindness and love. Your works are not in vain. I also wanted to express that a lot of people are in fear, and fear is a stumbling block of the end times. We have earth changes happening, cosmic changes happening. But fear is an emotion that can hinder things. I want to express my love for every being, because I do love everything. At this point, all of us has a form of duality or duplicity in our nature. And I don't want to judge others, but I do know that we as individual people, because individuality is what we need, people to be able to express their own way of living, their own way of being, but certain expressions, especially when it's dealing with little children. And it's bad to do certain things to children because you're stifling their ability to grow, their innocence of accepting what's around them. So I'm saying that judgment is justice, because it has to correct the wrong actions. And the universe is already aware of what it has to do to correct the actions. Because this earth that we're living on is a reflection of what we are inside. So we have to clear our minds. And in order to have real clear mind, we can't have mind control. So, my goal is to eliminate an Orwellian type world of mind control. Because each individual should have that right to control their own mind, not someone else controlling their mind. So let's give thanks to this day and be thankful that we have love, faith, and hope that still remains. I'm just thankful today, enjoying today. I know I haven't given much advice on health, how to heal yourself. My great-grandmother was a healer. She did not only heal with herbs, she healed with touching, and she healed with prayer. But faith is the noun, the sure expectation of things hoped for. You have to know it, feel it within. So, there's a lot of things we can do. And when I was small, I loved to be barefooted. And I still am barefooted a lot of the times because it's a way to ground you, to ground your energies, being barefooted. I like it. And I want to thank everybody that has participated in freeing me from this horrendous control machination that was placed upon me. Thank you. Bless you for knowing and for doing your part, because I do the same for those that are in that situation. Remember, faith, hope, and love still remains.